Hey everyone, it's Monica Scrapping for My Boys. So I'm here to announce my 4K / birthday challenge giveaway. Now before I get into it, first off, I just want to go ahead and say thank you to all of my old subscribers as well as my new subscribers. I greatly appreciate your support, especially those of you who like and comment on my videos. So for a while, I've been kind of teetering around the 3,800 mark. And I thought, you know what, let's go ahead and start prepping for a 4K giveaway. And then all of a sudden, mid-December to recently, something happened and I literally got like 350 subscribers. I'm over 4K now. I'm almost at 4,200. So thank you to all of those who have subscribed and welcome. And this kind of happened super fast, so I wasn't quite prepared to get this video out just yet. I thought I'd have a little bit longer to decide what I wanted to go ahead and do. So without making it too big of an ordeal, my birthday is around the corner. For those of you who don't know, my birthday is March 4th. So I figured I'd combine a 4K subby as well as my birthday in a little giveaway challenge. Now, this isn't going to be anything extremely over the top. But I just wanted to go ahead and do something. I haven't done anything as far as for my birthday, probably in about 2-3 years on my channel. And I haven't really had a big giveaway in a couple of years as well. I know I mentioned in a couple of videos back, I'm not big on giveaways because majority of the time you create a big prize. The person who wins, they're fine and dandy up until they receive their prize. And once they receive their prize, you never see from them again. You never hear from them again. They don't comment. They don't watch. They don't do any of that stuff. So I'm always really torn about giveaways. Now, I do want to reward those who are active on my channel, which I did mention a couple of videos back, that going forward, in order to be eligible to win a prize in any of my giveaways, you had to be an active subscriber. And that meant that you were watching and commenting on my videos and not one, you know, not a comment on every like 1 to 10 videos. You have to be relatively active. And I do plan on having more random surprise giveaways throughout the year. This one, however, I am going to go ahead and leave open. I know I have a lot of new subscribers in case anybody wants to join. But going forward, it will be in order to win something on my channel. Not only do you have to fulfill the requirements, but you also have to be an active subscriber, which means you watch, you comment, you like videos, all of that good stuff. So, with the prize, again, I was super torn on what I wanted to go ahead and do. So, we're going to have two little different options. Now, this giveaway, or challenge, I should say, it's open from today, January 11th. And I have to receive your item by February the 28th. If I don't get it by the 28th, then you're not going to be eligible to be entered into the drawing. Now, for the first part of the giveaway challenge, it's super easy. It's not going to be something over the top. You do have to mail something to me. For those of you who need my my shipping address, please email me directly and I will get you my shipping address when the time comes. Okay, so since this is for my birthday, it is also for my 4K subbies, but I'm going to gear this more towards my birthday. So, in order to enter into the giveaway drawing challenge, whatever you want to call it, you have to create a birthday card for me. Yes, that's it. Simple birthday card. I love to display birthday cards and anything anybody creates for me throughout my room. If you guys saw my room tour, I have a shelf on one of my walls and some smaller shelves on a different wall. And I like to interchange the cards and stuff that I've received from crafty friends and swaps up there so I can look at them at all times. So that is the main requirement as far as in order to enter into the main portion of the challenge. You have to create me a birthday card. It has to be A2 or larger. It can't be anything smaller. My one main thing for this, and I want to be very clear, there can be no pink in any way, shape, or form on the card project that you create for me. If there is any hint of pink, you will be disqualified. I will not enter you into the drawing. So please be sure to stick to that guideline. For those of you who don't know, and I'm sure plenty of you do, I despise the color pink. I cannot stand it. I hate it. I absolutely hate it. And I know that I struggle to watch a lot of projects from my fellow crafters because they use a lot of pink. And while I might be able to watch one video, I really can't stomach the color. It has nothing to do with the project. The project could be absolutely gorgeous, but anytime I see pink on there, it completely turns me off. I know it's my quirk. So that is the one main thing that is not allowed. No pink in any shade, not fuchsia. I can tolerate fuchsia sometimes, but no fuchsia, no dusty rose, no pink at all can be on my birthday card. So that birthday card you're going to create and you're going to mail to me. That birthday card will get you 3 entries into the main drawing. If you do a video response, that will give you 1 entry. Now, the video response only qualifies if you fulfill the original portion, which is the birthday card. If you don't send me a birthday card, even if you do a video response, it won't count. Your name won't be entered. The video response will only count if you do the initial birthday card. So by mailing in a birthday card and creating a video response, you have 4 entries into the drawing. Now, I did want to go ahead and do something a little bit extra. And let me grab a sample. And just give me a second. Okay, so these are going to be some small, simple samples. Now, I have these cards out in front of you just so you guys had something to look at. But let me move these really quickly. I'll put them back when I'm done. So let's move these off to the side. So in addition to the birthday card, as far as the main entry, you have the option of creating a separate project and mailing with your birthday card that will give you 10 bonus entries into the drawing, as well as 1 special entry into a separate drawing. And I'll get to that in just a minute. If you guys know, some of you do, some of you don't, I love vampires. My favorite vampire of all time is Eric Northman from True Blood. So, if you create a project for me featuring Eric Northman, that will give you 10 additional entries into the main prize drawing, and then 1 entry into the special drawing. Now, let me give you some examples. Now, with that being said, my birthday card, if you feature Eric Northman, does not qualify for the separate project. It has to be something separate aside from their birthday card. This is a good example. My friend, she is one of my crafty BFFs. Her name is Shelly Ann Crafts. Here on YouTube, Shelly Ann Crafts 00. She doesn't really post on YouTube anymore. You mostly find her on Instagram or Facebook. This is a birthday card she created for me years and years and years ago. It has Eric Northman on it. Absolutely love it. All of my different features, dark colors, metal, and my favorite vampire. She has also created this tag for me with Eric Northman on it. She's created this little tiny plaque with a picture of Eric on it. Whatever project you decide to create can be entirely up to you. I don't care what it is. A tag, a little mixed media canvas. It doesn't matter what it is. It is just something that involves Eric. So he is my absolute, absolute, absolute favorite. And you know what? Let's leave him here. Forget the cards because he's my love. And there's all kinds of other projects that she's created for me that I'm not going to pull over. But again, this gives you, if you create a vampy project, it gives you 10 additional entries into my challenge. Now, I know not everybody likes the whole vampire dark theme, so we can do another option. And actually, I'm kind of going on the fly with this one. I hadn't thought about it and written it down, so let me go ahead and change it. If you do a separate vampire project, gives you again 10 entries into the main drawing, and let's do 2 entries into the additional drawing that I'm going to be doing, because I'm going to give you another option. And that is, you can still create any other type of project that's separate from your birthday card. Other things that I love Legolas from Lord of the Rings. favorite. Love Lord of the Rings. I love Harry Potter. I love Winnie the Pooh and Tigger from Disney. Love them, love them, love them. I love Starbucks coffee. So you can choose to create a project with any of those themes. Legolas from Lord of the Rings. Winnie the Pooh and Tigger. What was the other thing I just mentioned? Coffee and Harry Potter. If you create some kind of project using that theme, that will also get you 10 entries into the regular drawing, but it will only get you one entry into the separate drawing. And the reason for that being is Eric is my all-time favorite love. So if you create something with Eric, because I know it's not easy to work with when it's something that's vampire related, that'll give you two drawings into the separate giveaway, and any of the other themes gets you one entry. So before we get started, you must be 18 years or older. I am opening this up to everybody. So you can be international or US. If you do happen to win as an international, I'll probably change the main prize just to avoid shipping fees. So as I mentioned, the only rule that you have is no pink in any way, shape, or form is allowed. Other things that you guys know that I love metal, I love bling. So you can incorporate that into what you create for me. Same thing, I love flowers. So you have creative reign aside from no pink as far as the birthday card is concerned. Any of the other projects, if you use a theme, again, only thing is no pink. Choose to create whatever it is that you want. But please be sure that your birthday card cannot be... you can create your birthday card as a theme, but it does not count as the additional project to do the 10 extra entries. You have to create a separate one. So the birthday card is one. The additional entries come from some other type of project. Again, because I'm on the fence of doing big big prizes for this main one, I am going to start off with, I know some of you probably won't be happy about it, but this is what I'm going to do because I have spent money, a good chunk of money, giving a large prize away, and it's completely disheartening. Every single person that's won, you've never heard from again. So I'm doing this a little bit different. I know a lot of people love my flowers, so... For the main drawing for the challenge, you're going to win a buttload of my handmade flowers. Whether I put it in a loaded envelope or however it is I create, I'm going to create a big chunk of handmade flowers for you in a variety of different colors. In a future later date, probably when I start showing the entries, I'll probably show the prize. And I'm going to say you're going to get at least, probably, I want to say maybe 40 flowers from me. I usually package my flowers in fours, so you'll probably get 10 package of flowers, of four flowers in each package. So you're going to get 40 handmade flowers in a variety of different styles. It won't just be 40 of one particular flower. I'll create a whole bunch of different styles of the flowers. That's going to be the prize for the regular standard giveaway. I could have done less flowers, but I did want to go ahead and at least do a little something. If you happen to be an international winner of the first drawing, I will probably change it up and do a cash prize via PayPal, because I don't want to ship anything out, because it's going to cost extra money to ship something international, because international shipping is not cheap. I highly doubt I'm going to get any internationals, so I'm not really too worried about it. As far as if an international person does win, I'll do a PayPal one, but I'm not going to go ahead and enter that because the cash PayPal prize will not be available to the winner of the original birthday card drawing. It is going to be the flowers if you're in the U.S. Now, for the second drawing, if you create the extra project for me, whether it's Eric Northman or the other themes, that one will be a cash prize because you are creating something that's more than just a birthday card. A birthday card doesn't cost that much to mail. Most people don't do over the top cards like I do. So for this one, since this is an extra added thing, I will be doing a cash prize. So for the second drawing, and you can only get into this drawing if you create a separate vampy project with Eric Northman or with the other themes. Again, Winnie the Pooh, Legolas from Lord of the Rings, Harry Potter, or Starbucks because I love Starbucks. If you create a separate project aside from the card, then that one, the winner, it will be a $25 cash PayPal prize. No questions asked. That's what it will be. And again, the separate project has to be, it can't just be a little 3x3 little ATC card, an ATC card or a little 3x3 square. It has to be something with a little oomph to it, you know, a tag, a little plaque, a little mini canvas, something. It has to be something separate. So if you do one of those, you will be entered into the second drawing, which will be a cash prize of $25 into your PayPal. Again, it has to be received. It has to be in my hands by February the 28th. Not postmark date, not the day after you drop it off at the post office. It has to be in my hands by February the 28th in order for you to be entered. If I get it afterwards, I'm sorry, but I will not enter you. The 28th is the deadline for when I have to have it in my hands. And that's about it. And just a quick note, I know I say this in my swaps as well. I know a lot of you who are my crafty friends, you guys love to send extra goodies. Please don't send them. I say it time and time again. I'm a very particular crafter. I'm very picky with the supplies that I use. So if you send stuff and it's not something that you know that I 100% will use, 9 out of 10 times I won't use it. Again, it will go into a bin where my sons or my nephews will go into and they'll use it when they craft. But I personally will not use it. And I know some get stubborn and they say that I'm stubborn. They want to send something anyway. If you really absolutely want to send me something, send me like, you know, a candy bar. I love chocolate. I love Twix and Snickers and any majority of milk chocolate as long as it doesn't have coconuts, you know. Kit Kats, Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. Send me a candy bar if you absolutely have to send something. I know some of you guys get upset at me when I tell you don't send me anything. But that's what I like. I like milk chocolate. I love Starbucks coffee. And that's all I can say. But it's not necessary. I don't need it. But I know that some of you get upset with me when I tell you don't send me something. So that's about it. If you have any questions, please comment below. As I start receiving entries, I will start showing them on my channel. I will group them together and show multiple in one entry. I'm not going to be doing a video for every single one that I get. Again, I don't expect this to be anything that's big. Any giveaway I've done in the past usually don't have very many entries. I'll be lucky if I get 10. So if I get 10, I'll be perfectly happy. If I get 1, I'll be perfectly happy. But yeah, this is your choice if you want to participate. I just want to say thank you to all of my supporters and all of my subscribers and my crafty friends. It's been a crazy journey. It's taken me forever to get to 4K subscribers. I started doing YouTube videos in 2011, so it's been a hot minute. I've been around for 9 years, and it's taken me that long to get to 4,000 subscribers, so I greatly appreciate all of those of you who have stuck with me and all of the new ones. It does mean a great deal to me. And that's it. Again, questions, comment below. I'm gonna quit rambling because this is long, as always. I am actually going to try to craft today. I've been itching to make a card, so hopefully my next video will be a card instead of a 3D project because I've been working a lot of 3D projects, but I haven't done any cards. And I know that most people subscribe to me predominantly because they think I am a card making channel, but I'm just a paper crafter. So while I love to create cards, I do love a lot of 3D projects as well as some mixed media. Okay, I'm out of here. I'll catch you guys in another video. Bye.